Welcome to the Windows Club. If you wish to fix Windows update error 0x800f0831 on your system, then either read through this article on the Windows Club or simply watch this video. I'll guide you through the resolutions. The first solution is to run the Windows update troubleshooter. Right click on the start button and select settings. In the settings window, go to the system tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, scroll down and select troubleshoot. Select other troubleshooters. Then you'll find the Windows update troubleshooter in the list. Click on run corresponding to it to invoke the same. The next solution is to manually install the feature or cumulative update in question. Go to catalog.update.microsoft.com and search for the update number in the search bar here. I'm taking a hypothetical number, you can take the exact one. Click on download corresponding to that update and install it on your system. The next solution would be to uninstall the VPN client or remove the proxy server. Now, to uninstall a VPN client, contact the VPN manufacturer. To remove the proxy server, the procedure is as follows. Right click on the start button and select settings. In the settings window, go to the network and internet tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select proxy. Then turn the switch on for automatically detect settings and turn it off for use a proxy server under manual proxy setup. The next solution would be to run an SFC scan on your system. Search for command prompt in the Windows search bar and click on run as administrator in the right pane to open the elevated command prompt window. In the elevated command prompt window, type the command SFC /. Scan now and hit enter to invoke the SFC scan. The last solution would be to perform a system restore. Search for recovery in the Windows search bar and click on this option to open the recovery panel. Now select open system restore. It will need a few seconds. Select a certain restore point, then click on next and finally on finish to invoke the system restore procedure. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.